Black history means to me that we as a people have the ability to conquer and overcome anything.
Black history is a reference to show us how to overcome the challenges that we face through love, unity, courage, and strength.
Kind of a celebration of all the things African Americans throughout history have accomplished. I think it's also a good time for people to become educated about the things that our ancestors have done and a reason that we should be proud of the Black community, and it's something to celebrate.
To me, Black history is learning about where I come from.
It's a celebration of lives. It's a celebration of how I am here today, standing here with you talking at Valdosta State University. This school is integrated. I'm able to climb the ladder without anyone saying, hey, this is not for you, your race or anything hinders you from growing.
Black history to me is remembering all the African Americans who fought for their equality today.
My definition of Black history is it's all history. It's a history that's been excluded, I believe, out of a lot of American culture in general, in our history books, our textbooks in school, but I believe it's very vital to know Black history because it brings everything together. If you're excluding one piece, then certain things aren't gonna make sense. So I believe it's very vital for our history.
If there's one thing that I could say to my fellow brothers and sisters and minorities, it would be that the sky is the limit, follow your dreams.
Keep going. Like, regardless of what society tries to teach you, regardless of what is constantly brought up to you, just keep going. Keep being the best of you possible. Keep achieving despite everything. You may have the obstacles, but just keep going.
Right now, don't lose faith, because as history shows, we're getting there, we're getting right, and we're getting equal. And everyone around us, Black, white, Hispanic, or Asian, we will all be friends.
Don't let society define what you can do. Don't let society define where you can go. Don't let your circumstances limit you and put you in a box. You can do anything you want to do, no matter the color of your skin.
If I could say anything to my brothers and sisters, I would say we just need to come together more, and not even only as black people, but I mean everybody, all brothers and sisters in general. And I believe it begins with the youth, like giving them guidance and just educating them on our history.
To stay gracious, to stay humble, to trust in God through every struggle, through everything.
First off, growing up in Africa is completely different from the way it has been shown in the American society today. I grew up learning English as my first language, and I grew up in schools that we can actually compare to the standards of school that are also here. For a while, we lived in a one-bedroom flat apartment. After that, my mom was able to get enough money to rent a house, and right now, as we speak, we live in our own house. Coming from a country that was Europeanized, that was once a European colony, we have to say we have a certain British spark to the way we speak English. So the use of language was what really took me aback, because I would say a word, I would spell a word, and someone would tell me I was spelling it incorrectly, but it's still the correct spelling, only with a bit of British flair. Black history on a level that is my level, being African, is way more than just talking about slavery. Black history goes back to our roots, to our ancestors, to when we're talking about when we actually lived in mud houses. Throughout all of those times, the slavery, because the slavery also affected us Africans, even if we didn't directly suffer from the slavery, we were still affected by slavery, going up to even the point of the European colonization.
Chicken. Everybody, I don't know not one person who does not like fried chicken. Especially Black people, everybody like fried chicken. My mama eat fried chicken, my daddy eat fried chicken.
my auntie, my grandma. Wait, I don't even know my daddy.
Being black, I get asked so many questions like, do I eat watermelon? Do I eat fried chicken? And I'm a vegetarian.
Yeah, are those new Jordans?
Is it because I'm black? These are definitely flip-flops.
I love watermelon. It's so good. Like, when I think of watermelon, I just be like, it's so good. Like, I could eat some right now, to be honest. Like, I'll go to my grandma's house because she got a watermelon patch in her backyard. And we just eat watermelon. The whole family come over there and we just eat watermelon.
You got a problem? We can handle this outside. No, forget even going outside. We can handle this right now.
What's tipping? No, I don't do that. Tip for what? It's already like, I came to your restaurant. So what am I tipping you for?
If you want to take it further, we can do that too. It's up to you.
Tired of the way he treats me.
Tired
of the guilty feelings.
Tired
of the broken dreams.
Tired
of the public things. Tired of the baby mama.
Tired
of the ghetto drama.
My name is Amari Devon Banks Hort III. I was born in Stone Mountain. I was raised in
the metro Atlanta. And as a kid, I moved around a lot. But, you know, that was cool because, you know, moving around a lot, you get to see a lot of new things and experience new stuff like that, learn a lot of new things. So, yeah.
Music inspires me, so I make music for my community. I wouldn't say that it makes me, you know, want to go out and, you know, do things like pick up trash. But what it does do is it gives me something to be inspired about. So that's what I make music for.
What got me started in music, that's actually a crazy story. I met this weird kid, come to find out, like, years later down the road, he ended up being my bro. I met him in the Boys and Girls Club, and it was crazy because he was just listening to this beat, this instrumental by Dom Kennedy called Dream to Me, and he was rapping. I was like, yo, kid, you rap real nice. And he was like, man, anybody can do it. And it just went from there. One day I started it, and I never stopped. The Civil Rights Movement, I feel like more people should be inclined to learn about, you know, the history that their past, that, you know, their granddads and great-granddads, great-grandmas came from, and learn about, you know, just the things that happen like that, so history never repeats itself.
Many people wonder where my secret lies. I'm not cute or built to suit a fashion model size. When I start to tell them, they think I'm telling lies. I say, it's in the reach of my arms, the span of my hips, the stride of my step, the curl of my lips. I'm a woman, phenomenally. I walk into a room just as cool as you please, and to a man the fellows stand or fall down on their knees. Then they swarm around me, a hive of honeybees. I say, it's the fire in my eyes, the flash of my teeth, the swing in my waist, the joy in my feet. I'm a woman, phenomenally. Men themselves have wondered what they see in me. They try so much, but they can't touch my inner mystery. When I try to show them, they say they still can't see. I say, it's in the arch of my back, the sun of my smile, the ride of my breasts, the grace of my style. I'm a woman, phenomenally. Now you understand just why my head's not bowed. I don't shout or jump about or have to talk real loud. When you see me passing, it ought to make you proud. I say, it's in the click of my heels, the bend of my hair, the palms of my hands, the need for my care. Because I'm a woman, phenomenally, phenomenal woman. All you women and me.